Sam, thank you. Well, sickle cell disease affects about 100,000 Americans. The disease can be marked by pain and infection. Saturday is Sickle Cell Awareness Day, and here to help us understand more is Dr. Amandeep Aujla, medical oncologist at Backus Hospital. Doctor, welcome.
Thank you for having me today here.
Oh, it's my pleasure. So what exactly is sickle cell disease?
So sickle cell disease is a disorder of red blood cells, and as you mentioned, affecting almost about 100,000 individuals in the United States. So red blood cells, normally they have a shape similar to a frisbee, and they're really flexible, which helps them pass through the blood vessels and transport oxygen to all parts of the body with the help of a protein called hemoglobin. So in sickle cell disease, this hemoglobin becomes dysfunctional and really sticky and makes these long rods inside these cells and changes their shape into a C-shaped farming tool called sickle, and that's the name of the disease, called sickle cell disease.
All right, doctor, tell us, what are the symptoms?
So the number of these abnormal cells could vary in these individuals, and any kind of stress or events like infection, dehydration, or changes in weather could increase these number of these abnormal cells. And these cells, they are not that much flexible and can block the blood vessels, obstructing the supply of oxygen to parts of the body. So individuals could experience episodes of severe pain, infections, skin ulcers, stroke, or difficulty breathing.
Okay, very serious. Who is at risk for getting sickle cell disease?
So it is a hereditary disorder, and a person needs to inherit at least two copies of abnormal gene from each parent to have a full presentation of the disease. If an individual inherits only one copy, they are called sickle cell trait, and they usually do not develop much symptoms.
All right, doctor, tell us, what are the latest treatments that are available at places like Backus Hospital?
Sure. So this is a lifelong disease, and at present, unfortunately, the only cure is a stem cell transplant. But we have different kind of treatments available, which are aimed at preventing the complications from sickle cell disease and managing them, which are available in form of pills as well as through the intravenous route. And in severe cases, individuals could benefit from blood transfusions or exchange transfusion, wherein we replace these abnormal cells with normal red blood cells.
All right, last quick question. Tell us about a patient you've treated and how the treatment maybe changed their life for the better.
Sure. I remember one patient that inherited from previous practice, and she was having a lot of pain crises, which was lasting 2 to 3 times a month. And we started her treatment. We individualized the treatment based on her symptoms and risks. So she did improve, and her quality of life has improved remarkably with the medications and treatments available.
Excellent. All right, Dr. Amandeep Aujla, thank you so much for joining us.
It was my pleasure. Thank you.